Introduction to Control System. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to define control system. Explain the components of the control system. Development in science made our life easier by introducing electrical, mechanical, and electromechanical systems. The concept of control system plays a vital role in controlling these systems in order to achieve the desired performance. To know more about control system, let us consider the driving system of an automobile. Speed of the automobile can be controlled by properly positioning its accelerator. Here, speed is a function of the accelerator position. The driver has to change the accelerator position to increase the vehicle speed by increasing the force on the accelerator. This will increase the volume of the fuel which is burnt in the combustion chamber of the engine. As a result, more power will be produced, which will increase the vehicle's speed. The speed can be reduced by reducing the force on the accelerator. Here, the force which is given to the accelerator is called as input or command signal. The accelerator, the carburetor, and the linking mechanism between them are collectively called as controller. The engine and the vehicle are together called as the controlled system. Finally, the speed of the vehicle is called as the output or the controlled variable. The block diagram shown in the screen represents the control system of an automobile. This block diagram is modified in such a way that it is applicable to any system. In addition to this, a few more components are added to the system to improve reliability and accuracy. Let us learn the basic components of the control system. The basic components of the control system are command signal, reference input element, reference input, error detector, feedback element, error signal, controller, output forcing function, controlled system, controlled variable. Command signal is the external interrupt which is given by the user or the automated mechanism to control the output parameter of the system, like speed, velocity, position, torque, current, voltage, power, etc. The output parameter which is to be controlled is called the controlled variable. The interrupt or the command signal could be of any form, like analog, digital, etc. It should be processed in order to convert it to the form suitable for the error detector. The component that performs this task is called the reference input element. The output of the reference input element is called reference signal. This reference signal is given to the error detector, which estimates the error in the system by comparing it with the actual value of the controlled variable. The value of the controlled variable is estimated at the output using sensing devices like encoder, TACO generator, current or potential transformer, LVDT, etc. Output of the error detector indicates the difference between the actual value and the required value of the controlled variable. Hence, this is called an error signal. Controller could be either electrical or mechanical or electromechanical or electronic element that generates control signal to drive the system based on the received error signal. This control signal is also called as an output forcing function. Hence, the output of the system reaches the desired value based on the command signal given by the user or the automated mechanism. In this way, the components of the control system function to control the process or the system. Summary. This brings us to the end of the lesson. In this lesson, we have learned definition and role of the control system. The basic components of the control system. The functions of the components of control system.